If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now. What's up guys, welcome to Mad Stuff with Rob. I am Rob and I'm back with another DIY. And this DIY will make all you Harry Potter fans super happy because I am making a spell book. But wait, before you get all excited, this is not a Harry Potter spell book, but a Harry Potter inspired spell book. So this is a more generic design, but you can use this technique and make your design from the Harry Potter series. Sounds fair? Okay then, get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. All right, let's make a spell book. And this one is not a regular spell book, but it has a secret chamber. Sounds interesting, right? Okay, so I have these boxes lying around. So I am using two to make our spell book. And I'm going to cut some cavities here where I'll store things. And that will be our secret chamber. And for the cover, I am using mount board sheets like this. So you can see I have already cut it to size. So we'll get the boxes out and I'll show you first how we can make the cover. I have two pieces here, the top and bottom cover. We will also use another mount board strip for the seam of the book. Now I am going to take a chart paper. Now I'm using a brown chart paper because I want to give this spell book an old vintage kind of look. So to stick this, I am using Fevicol MR, which comes in this new fun bottle, Ellie the elephant. So let's apply some Fevicol. Okay, now that the mount board pieces are in place, we will fold the chart paper and cover it nicely. Again, we'll use some Fevicol to stick it in place. Okay, we are done. So you can see we have a nice clean cover. And now you can place the boxes inside like this and it looks like a book. Look at that. So now what we can do is, because we have a cover ready, and we have our secret chamber inside, we need to make this look impressive. So the first thing that I'm going to add on this is this piece of jute. So I took an old bag and I cut a small piece out. Okay, so let's stick this. Okay, so we have a nice texture. The next thing that I'm going to add is a frame. So for that, I have cut a small frame like this. This is foam sheet. So let's apply some Fevicol and stick this in place. So this is done. Now let's give this a more mystical or scary look. I am going to use some fabric glue and make a spider web on this. Okay, so the spider web is ready. Looks pretty nice. We can keep this aside for drying. Until then, we'll use the boxes and we'll make our secret compartment. Now to make the secret compartment, I took a mount board piece. Now I'll just take the measurement using this as a template. Now I'll use a ruler and cut this out cleanly. As you can see, we have two cavities here and these will act as the secret compartment or the secret chamber. Okay, so this is done. Let's check the cover. Okay, so the cover is also ready. Let's place the boxes back inside. There you go. And because we have a spider web, I am going to add a spider to this. Now I am taking this plastic spider. You can stick it in place. I've also cut these circular pieces out of foam sheet to add some more details, like in the corners, small rivets. All right, so the spider is in place and so are the rivets. So now I'm happy with the detailing. So let's wait for this to dry. And while this is drying, we will move inside and stick the boxes in place. Okay, so we are done with the boxes. Now we move to this side and I'll take a plain sheet of paper and just stick it here so that our book cover looks neat. Okay, this is done. Now we will stick the seam to the box like this. Look at that, we are done. So now the seam is attached to the boxes and you can see it opens up nicely like a book. Now what we need to do is we will add another sheet of paper on this to basically hide all these joints. So I have another sheet of paper right here and you can see I have already cut the cavity size and you can see that this looks slightly more yellowish than the regular paper. That's because I have aged it using some coffee. So you can just mix some coffee in water, dilute it, and then give it a coat and you will get this aged look. And following the same technique, I also took some printouts like this and coated it with coffee and got this aged look. So I'm gonna stick these sheets on the book so that it looks like a real book and we will hide the cavity under the sheets. So when you open, you have a hidden compartment or a secret chamber. All right, so the cover is done and we have put the printouts in place. Now we need to hide the edges. For that, I have these photocopies. So I took a book and I just took a photocopy of the side. And I did the same thing. I took some coffee and did the aging effect on that. And we will stick it on the side. Okay, so we are done with all the detailing. And now we need to give this a nice old vintage look. So for that, I am going to coat this in a dark color and then give some nice metallic highlights. Okay, we are done with our metallic finish. I'm pretty happy. And now for the final finishing touch. I also made this little card using the same foam sheet and regular chart paper. And I wrote Book of Spells on that. And now we are going to stick this. And with that, we are done. Look at that. Looks pretty neat. Let's open and check. What is that? A secret compartment. So now you can just leave this on your table and hide your things in this and no one will dare to touch your Book of Spells. And that's how you make a spell book or a book of spells. So if you enjoyed this technique and you want to follow this technique and make this book, please try it or make your own design. You can make them bigger or smaller or make a whole series of them. Just be creative. So if you like this technique and you enjoyed watching this video, then please give it a big thumbs up, like, share and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have, then a big thank you. And if you haven't, then I will cast a spell on you. Spell of love. So then you will subscribe to my channel. If you're trying this, then please click pictures and share them with me. You know how to get in touch with me. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and right here in the YouTube space, making DIY videos just for you guys. I'll see you in my next video. Until then, do good and be good. Peace.